When you sit down to begin your research, you might question the extra step of seeking out a specialized or subject database if you think that front page searches like Quicksearch or Google Scholar will do the job well enough. In this video, we're going to compare generalized search tools with subject-specific and specialized databases. We'll identify some of the advantages that specialized databases have over large, multidisciplinary search tools, and look at how you can choose the right specialized database to answer your research question. Let's begin by taking a look at the Quicksearch and Google Scholar tools on the main page of the USF Libraries website, lib.usf.edu. These are both multidisciplinary search tools, which means they find a lot of different information on a lot of different subjects. Quicksearch pulls from USF library databases, as well as its library catalog, and Google Scholar searches the web. Both tools can be a great asset for research, particularly at the beginning of the research process. But what are the disadvantages of generalized searching? Well, the USF Library's Quicksearch is a product of one specific company, ProQuest. And while it doesn't only include databases and content from that company, it does exclude some useful content from other providers. For instance, it doesn't search one of the most well-regarded multi-subject databases, Academic Search Premier. There's another big reason to consider using specialized or subject-specific databases over a federated search tool like Quicksearch. Specialized subject-specific databases like PsycINFO, PubMed, and ERIC have large lists of subject terms that you can use to search. These lists are known as thesauri, subject terms, or controlled vocabulary, and they're specific words that have been assigned to describe every item indexed in a particular database. They allow you to find the subject terms which best match with your research topic. Research databases use subject terms or controlled vocabulary to categorize materials according to subject so that all the items on the same topic will have the same subject heading. Because subject terms go straight to the main topic of an article or book, searching in specialized databases and taking advantage of the controlled vocabulary means you'll likely get fewer but more relevant results. You can also use a database's thesaurus to get ideas for more terms and subjects to search. Articles will generally fall under a few different subject terms, giving you more to explore. So what does this have to do with choosing a specialized database over simply using Quicksearch? Quicksearch isn't able to use those subject terms. Because it combines so many different databases, there's no way it could factor in each individual database's special list of subject terms. Because of this, going to specialized databases and using the controlled vocabulary to search offers much more powerful and directed searching. The second major reason to look at specialized databases? Because Quicksearch is the product of a specific company, ProQuest, some important specialized databases created by other companies are not indexed in it. You may be familiar with the two really big scholarly database companies, EBSCO and ProQuest. EBSCO might be the giant Coke product of article databases, but ProQuest is like Pepsi, equally large, with many other products to offer. This means that serious researchers might miss some very important resources if they were only to use the Quicksearch. The easiest way to find the best discipline-specific specialized databases is to use our library guides. Go to the USF Libraries homepage, click the Guides/How-To button in the navigation bar at the top of the site, and choose Subject and Course Guides, and check out the guide for the subject that best fits your research question. So now that you know that specialized databases can offer you more and even better ways to search the literature, how do you know which one to select when working on a research question? Generally, specialized databases are organized by discipline, so matching your question to the correct area of study will help you select the best databases. Being able to classify research questions by discipline and then by specialized database can help researchers investigate questions systematically and thoroughly. For example, perhaps you're looking into how social workers can collaborate with school officials to help families with severely disabled children. Social services abstracts would be a great place to find essential social work literature. I hope this tutorial clarifies the difference between large multidisciplinary finding tools and specialized databases. Both can be very useful depending on what stage of the research process you're in and how deeply you want to research a topic. If you have questions about this or any other USF Library resource, visit lib.usf.edu and click on Ask a Librarian for lots of ways to get your questions answered.